Hey guys, it's Gary here with Upton Bass. This is another exciting bass for us, one of those model basses, of course. This is the Gary Carr version 2. When I'm recording this video, it's yet to be released, but this is the Gary Carr version 2. We've got further ergonomics, really taken what we were doing with the Carr bass, and pretty much at the ISB in 2011, after meeting with Jim Hamm and seeing what Jim does for Gary's basses, you know, the bass that he made Gary, and for some of Gary's students like Han and Jonathan Camps, I wanted to build in these great thoughts. And they really haven't changed the general build of the bass, but they've just made it insanely approachable and playable. The shoulders, they're very aggressively sloped coming into the neck block. So, I mean, I'm all the way up the fingerboard and hardly even touching the upper bout. I mean, the bass, for me, it's almost like too small feeling. But what's not too small is its sound. It is very long in the body still, so you're not losing dimension. It's got the playability, the tighter string spacing that Gary has us do on the basses, the arch to the bridge. All of these things really add to an instrument that is just, you know, insanely playable. So, I mean, you can see the nice tall overstand, nice high fingerboard projection, longer C bouts than were in the previous Carr. They are 1.5 inches longer to really help facilitate the bow clearance, especially as you get playing really on the bridge, higher up in thumb position, which I won't do to you guys. But as you're playing further up on the bridge, you're not nailing that corner. You know, the back of the instrument tapering in to the 6.25-inch neck block. Again, still not lacking in sound, not lacking in general proportion. The bass from the bridge down has all the dimensions that all the other Upton basses have. I feel like before on the Carr version 1 Upton bass, we kind of took what Upton bass did and made it work for Gary, and he was very happy, and we've got tons of customers that love those basses. However, when I met with him and saw what he was, what Jim had done on the instruments, building in the approachable, playable elements like the neck block, it only made sense to say, scratch that idea, let's redo this. I mean, people think of this bass as a solo bass, or, you know, not a section bass. It's got all that. You know, hear me playing arco on the lower strings. And then for jazz, I mean, this bass still carries a lot of junk in the trunk, good pizzicato sound. You know, if you're a straight jazz guy, I'd go after one of the Bressians or one of our Bohemian models. But if you are a classical, doing some solo work, some section work, and you do a little bit of jazz, perfectly good bass.